And here we go. The finals are set. Andreas Backrud, Ollie Eriksson. Again, who's going to hold up that top qualifier trophy, get the sticker on their car like a fighter pilot? Norwegian, Sweden, both two very talented. You can see the accolades there. 2020 RallyX Nordic champion, seven-time career World RX wins, champions, and bragging rights is at stake here.
And yeah. current European rally champion. Oliver, actually, he was out there earlier. He had a little bit of an issue, but we were, I mean, three-way battle for the lead on that one. Ollie has been in the mix all day long. He struggled his way up from the bottom of kind of the qualifying, and he's all the way in the final. So I'd say Andreas being on the inside has a good shot, but Eriksson knows this track like the back of his hand, yep. And he is exploiting it.
Travis, talk us through what you do in the car now to get this launch done. We've not had you up here to talk us through
good a start. Point.
We're seeing people staring at the dashboard. Tell us what they're doing.
So you're staring at the dash, 30 seconds to go. Basically, everyone, you're getting in and drive. You're figuring out, you got all kinds of different settings. So you're going over your data with all the engineers and saying, okay, I should be 7 on the, you know, say, what was he? Oh, 10, 10, and 5. That is very good information for me tomorrow. So they are maximum. So he's going to be playing with the throttle. So he's got about half throttle as opposed to full throttle, where I'm playing with 7, you know, and giving it just maximum throttle so I don't over rev it. But yeah, all kinds of different stuff. Everything's in the driver's hands, and we are about to go nitro, guys.
All right, here we go. Andreas Backrud, Ollie Eriksson. We saw how well Ollie Eriksson got that pass going out to in. Can he execute that on Andreas Backrud?
He's going around the outside.
No. Oh, he goes around the outside, and we got contact, people. Backrud forces him out of the way. He holds on to that lead. Ollie Eriksson, a little bit of damage, but not too much.
Backrud did not give him an edge. He's like, nope, I'm taking this lead.
Backrud moved across the second he took the start. Eriksson just edged him at the actual moment of the start, but he moved out to claim some territory immediately on the run to the first corner. Eriksson did try it anyway. He's like, nah, you're not having it. And then ran him all the way across to the side of the course as well.
Are you looking at his numbers again too?
I was looking at the other person's numbers. So he's on 8.
Yeah, Ollie.
So Ollie's on 8. Backrud's on 10. Backrud is doing everything with his foot. So you'll notice Backrud can easily get it sideways, where Ollie's kind of using a little bit more of the car to help him with that traction.
So Backrud told me a brilliant story in Hollius earlier this year about how he compared data with Mattias Ekström about how much they use the pedals. It was fascinating, the difference between them, and a different strategy here.
All right, so Andreas Backrud out front, but you saw Ollie Eriksson take that Yokohama tire Joker lap. All purple for Backrud, green for Ollie, so obviously, you know, just getting better. And it looks like Andreas is still dancing inside the car. I'm joking. He's obviously steering the wheel, feeding the wheel. But yep. Still parting out front, Andreas Backrud.
So, well, Backrud is, he's driving very, very tidy. He's going to make Oliver take the race from him. So this is really interesting because Ollie is not going to leave anything on the table. There's a chance that Ollie could make this distance right back up. But as you see, not making the mistakes through that paved section is really helping Andreas. And I'm amazed at he's up to 10. He's got all like 1,000 horsepower at his toe tips, if you will.
He's gone purple again, Jared. It was 2.9. It's now 3.1. So Andreas Backrud edging the gap a little on Eriksson as he comes in super tight on the tires onto the start finish straight. What is it as they go across the line? Does the gap come down? 2.4. Eriksson's taken a massive chunk out of him on that last sector. He's taken 0.7 of a second out of Backrud. Did you see where that was? Is that a mistake or just pure brilliance from Eriksson?
No, Eriksson's got, he's got his power down. So when he comes out on that dirt, he's able to feed it a little bit easier getting down that straightaway. But now when we hit the pavement section, like coming out of this corner, having more power, Backrud's going to be able to accelerate a little bit harder up that hill where you're going to see this car's a little more lethargic. So there's different sections of the track that do different with that. So this, thanks for inviting me. I've learned so much.
You're welcome anytime. But ideally, you want to be down on the track. So, you know, he lost it right back. So to your point, you know, that navigation. Now, so final lap here, 2.9 seconds. And there goes Andreas Backrud for that Joker lap. All right, so Andreas Backrud.
Here we go.
Ollie Eriksson, could he get him? And he does. Ollie Eriksson with that 2.9. Great execution. Interesting philosophy. You talked about that 8 as opposed to the 10. What works out perfect? What is just... And it obviously, Ollie delivered.
First ever top qualifier for Oliver Eriksson here for the Allsberg MSC team who built these cars. The Larsen fan club, they're shaking their head.
Eriksson
down the side of the car. That's more like
we
it.
We got the Solberg total jumping out the side. This is this means so much. I know everyone's like, oh, it's just a point. It's just this is what the championship's about. The one-on-one is my favorite part. And to say straight up that you beat everybody else that's in that field one-on-one is an awesome feeling. So congratulations to Ollie. What a heck of a run.
Great stuff.
Yeah,
Backwood,
really well done.
Backwood had that, didn't he? And then just 7/10 were gone in that one. But he gets that. Oh, he's going to go over. Andreas Eriksson, bottom of your screen, walking up to his son. Remember, Kevin not racing. Having done all the development work on this car as a broken ankle. Great moment for this family who worked so hard, didn't they, to get these cars
beyond
ready.
Beyond hard. I mean, they were, that's honestly, that's the only reason Kevin's hurt. He was testing my car at midnight the day before our first practice in these vehicles, trying to make sure that everyone has the best possible vehicles, that this FC1X is the best car that's anywhere in the world for racing. And they put their heart and soul into it. And see Oliver come out. And man, he just put the power to the ground. He did not overdrive. It was amazing.
So turn one, Backwood moved out. He claimed a bit of territory. Eriksson did have the better start. He got in the door. It's kind of, that's all right. You know, we don't want the stewards to stop everything. That's Rallycross. And just nudged him out a little bit wide. The gap at one point was 3.1, which I really thought was enough. And then just on that second lap, 0.7 seconds. So that's perfection from Eriksson. Maybe a little mistake from Backwood as well, Travis.
Well, Backwood was actually, when they told him that Eriksson was really close, he stepped it up a little bit, and he just was not. When you come out of the dirt, you have to be very, very, like you watch here on the inside, just nice and easy with that throttle. Gets it straight lined, and he is gone out of there.
Really, really fun to watch. I love how excited you are as a racer being up here. But the most excited, they're down there on the ground. Obviously, Andreas Backwood slightly a little less excited with Ollie Eriksson. Down to you, Neil.
So Oliver Eriksson, top qualifier. The crowd will give you a round of applause. Make some noise. There we go. So first of all, talk us through how you did it.
Yeah, I don't know. I had a good start. I tried to block him off, but he had the line there in turn one. Yeah, and then he pulled a bit, but I was quick in the gravel. So I got there and joked it early, and it was tight at the end, but it worked.
Okay. Well, the first thing you have to do is stick the top qualifier sticker on the side of your car. So let's watch you do that. It's a big deal. On the body. There we go. Round of applause. Congratulations, Ollie. And you also get this, the top qualifier trophy. There we go. So you've got the trophy. You carry that and the confidence through to tomorrow. So tell us what your plan is in terms of position for the heat and which heat.
Yeah, I want to race heat two. But it's not the rallycross tomorrow, so pole doesn't mean you got anything. So, but finally I got hardware from Nitro, so yeah, I'm pleased with that.
Well, wave it at the camera and I'll go and find Andreas Backwood, who's over there. Andreas, let's have a word. That was a great clean fight.
Yeah, it sure was. I mean, it sure was. But first and foremost, I think Ole did a great job. He was super quick all day, and you know how much this family have been working here for Nitro to make this happen. So, I mean, not only for Ole, but Kevin, which is sick or has some problem with his foot, and Maria especially, and Andreas, the crazy man himself, for putting up a great show with the cars. I mean, the cars are epic. They're so fast, and I think the crowd likes it. So, yeah, it's good to be here, and nice to be up there fighting.
Yeah, it's very gracious of you because, of course, so much work has gone on behind the scenes. But do you think there is a slight advantage that people who know this circuit a little better than some others?
Yeah, but I mean, I can't say I don't know the circuit because I've been testing here a bunch, especially with the Hoenigan Racing Division. All the World Championship teams have come here in the spring, tested a bunch of laps. So I'm one of them. I just got beaten fair and square against Oliver. And I need to do some homework for tomorrow.
Yeah, let's get the brain in gear and get you out there on track again tomorrow. Well done.
Thank you very much.
There we go.
The cheer and just the energy right now is really cool. Again, Eriksson outside his door. He's got the Swedish flag. And Backrood, he's got his, you know, the Backrood Blue crew.